Hi guys, today I'm going to discuss about Taylor's expansion, okay, which is there in mathematics 1 engineering. So again, we need to know simple differentiation. We all know what log x is what? D by dx of log x is 1 by x. So d by dx of 1 by x is what? Minus 1 by x square. Up to that, minus 1 by x square, it is 2 by x cube. And 2 by x cube is what? Minus x by x power 4. So like that, it goes on. Okay. So here also, we'll use only simple differentiation thing. Once we know the simple differentiation thing, it's very, very easy to do. So let's do the Taylor expansion series. Okay. So let's see this formula. For this particular thing, we have to know what the formula. Okay. For everything, we got to know the formula. F of x is equal to f of a plus x minus a into f dash of a, this box. Plus x minus a the whole square by 2 factorial to f double dash of a plus x minus a the whole cube by 3 factorial to f double dash of a, and so on. Okay. And there is one more series associated with this, that is the Maclaurin series. Taylor's and Maclaurin. Okay. So Maclaurin series is nothing, but if I just put this a as 0, then it becomes what? Maclaurin. So it is as easy. Once you know one series, the other series is very, very easy. So no need for us to worry. So let's see an example on how to do this particular thing. See, as I told you, the first example, expansion of log x about x is equal to 1. So what I told you first thing is we should know simple differentiation, because here they given y1, y2 and all. Okay. See, y is the thing, but the first one itself, the log x thing. But what about y1 first time differentiation, y2 second time differentiation? Log's differentiation is what for the first time? 1 by x. Again, if I differentiate y2, means again differentiate 1 by x, what will get? Minus 1 by x square. Again, we are using only a simple formula, nx power n minus 1. That's it. So log x is what? 1 by x. Okay, 1 by x means you should take what? X power minus 1 to the top. So nx power n minus 1, minus 1 x power minus 1 minus 1. So minus 1 x power minus 2. So that's how we get what? Minus 1 by x square respectively. So that is that easy to do it. So if they tell you up to 4 term, then you need to do differentiation up to 4 term. Okay, that's it. So very, very easy and well below the level, these kind of questions. And after doing each thing, you have to substitute what? The x value, one value to put. Y of 1, 1. Y of 2, very easy thing. So only concept which we note here is what? Differentiation thing. Okay, let's come back to this thing. Then we substitute in the formula. Okay, the formula. Y of 1. log 1 value, y of 1, see y of x is what is given the question, log x, log 1 is what? 0, log 10 is what? 1. If you don't know that thing, take your calculator and just put log 1, that's it, easy as that. Then substitute the values in this thing. What values? What is y1 of 1, which I calculate here? 1, that's it. And then one more question for us is, do we need to simplify these things? Absolutely not. Okay. For example, if you want, I can just cut 6 4 to 24. I can just write these things. But I don't need to do further thing for getting more marks. If you're able to do this much, they'll give you the full mark in this. And then proving is what? Obtain log of 1.1 value. So in calculator, you should take ln, ln 1.1, not log 1.1. You should take ln 1.1 and then the compute the value first itself. Okay. Then directly you put down the answer. Without doing anything, you'll get the full and put it in a box, then you'll get the full mark for the same. Next thing is what? Tan inverse of x. For this, we should know what? D by dx of tan inverse of x. We should know d by dx of tan inverse of x. What is the answer? 1 by 1 plus x square. So d by dx of tan inverse of x is what? 1 by 1 plus x square. Okay, so that is that easy. Only thing is simple differentiation terms we have to know, but only thing is that again, I cannot sit and do u by v rule for this. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll take y1. I'll take y1 is equal to 1 by 1 plus x square. And for the next term, what will I do? I will, instead of y1, I'll put y2. I won't do u by v rule, no, nothing. Okay, is that easy as that? Fine. So let's see how they have done this particular thing. See, y1 is first differentiation. Okay, so this is our y1 value, 1 by 1 plus x square. Cross multiply this thing. And what is our second term? Y2? Y2 in the sense, what do you do? In this question, same thing. Differentiate here. UV rule. What is UV rule? U dash V plus UV dash U. That's all. Okay. U dash V plus UV dash U. So take the u term constant. Differentiate your y1 is what? Y2. Next thing, 1 plus x square, you differentiate. What is x square differentiation? 2x. Y1 is what? That's a constant. And differentiate constant is 0. That's it. So similarly, then you have to put the value of x is equal to 1 and you get y2. What is the value? Similarly for y3, again do uv rule on this. 1 plus x square and y2, that is uv rule. And 2xy1 and again 2 as constant, xy1 is again what? UV rule. So if you are able to do the UV rule, you'll get the answer respectively. So you can just pause the video and just see where you're having, where you, whether you're able to get it or not. Okay. So, and next question, let's take the next question. Okay. Second, yeah. Expand sine pi by 4 plus h in ascending process h power 1, find the value of sine 50. So first take the calculator and find the value of sine 50. Okay, these questions may not be asked, but I'll tell you what is the logic. Okay. Again, in this particular kind of question, sine 45, what is the value? 1 by root 2. Sine 45 also 1 by root 2. So pi by 4 plus h. So if I'm just taking the four quadrants I'm taking. Okay, the four quadrants. So sine will be positive in first quadrant, what? Positive, 1 by root 2. Second quadrant, again positive. Third quadrant, minus 1 by root 2. Fourth quadrant, minus 1 by root 2. So that's how it is actually coming up. Okay, so we don't need to do even this. But if you have any doubt, what is y? Sine x. What is y1? Difference sine x is cos x. Cos x is what? Minus sine x. Then again, take the calculator and put pi by 4. But only thing is that you have to change your calculator mode from degree to radian. Degree to radian. Because if you use pi, you have to do what? Radian thing. Kindly note down that same thing. So that is the only thing in this. And one more thing, one more logical question which I'll ask you. In college, they won't explain you this also. Why we are taking h is equal to 5 degree? Why we are taking h is equal to 5 degree? Okay, just see this thing. Sine pi by 4 plus h. I can take so a lot of things, right? But only reason I took h as 5 degrees because the question here is what? Sine 50 degree and pi by 4 is 45. 45 plus 5 will give me 50 degree. That is the reason they have taken pi. Because if you don't know mathematics properly, then you will never be able to figure out this particular question. So I hope everyone had a good session enjoying the Taylor series. Okay, and I wish you all the best and hope you get full marks in your examination. Thank you.